This article was taken from the book Population of the Philippine Islands in 1916, written by Henry Otley Beyer, 1883 to 1966. Tagbanua. They number about 19,460. They are located in the mountainous interior of the island of Palawan. They are most numerous near the center of the island, though found throughout its length. At one time, the Tagbanuas probably occupied all of the Calamianes and Cuyu Islands, as well as Palawan, and possibly a considerable portion of the Sulu Archipelago. However, most of them have now been absorbed into the Christian and Mohammedan population. The Tagbanua are pagan. Physically, the Tagbanuas are predominantly of the Indonesian type, though a majority of the women show much short Mongol mixture. There are a few mixed Papuan types and a considerable number of the Malay blend. There are at least three well-marked culture groups in northern, central, and southern Palawan. The northern group is the most primitive. Very little clothing is worn, the chief garment of both men and women being a small tapa clout. A large part of their food is obtained from the sea, though a primitive dry agriculture is practiced. They are not known to possess a written alphabet. The people of Central Palawan are much more advanced and are usually known by the name of Apurahuanon or Aburlanon after the names of two of their largest settlements, Apurawan and Aburlan. The blowgun is still their typical weapon, but their clothing and house types have been greatly affected by contact with their Christian neighbors. A certain amount of dry agriculture is practiced. The folklore and religious beliefs are highly interesting, while for written communication, one of the old Philippine syllabic alphabets is still in use. Unlike the Southern Mangyans, the only other Philippine group known to still possess such an alphabet, the Tagbanuas write in vertical columns, reading from top to bottom and from right to left. The Southern group of Tagbanuas speak a different dialect and are usually known as Palawans or Palawanes. Their general culture is similar to the Central group. Part of them have been Mohammedanized and have already been described under the name Palawan. In the Bay of San Antonio, there is said to exist another small group of people called Kanoy. They differ considerably from the Tagbanuas and have not as yet been identified. The people of Palawan are deserving of careful study from both the linguistic and cultural standpoint. The only Tagbanua dialect that is well known is that of the Central group, which bears a certain resemblance to Sulu.